So I want to talk about phono stages for a moment, because I was with you during the birth of the stellar phono stage, and I know right now you are working on a perfect wave phono stage, which is going to be sometime maybe in 2021, I'm guessing.
Yes.
We'll have it out.
Absolutely.
And it's very exciting. I remember when you started on the Stellar, you went through a lot of iterations of change. You had circuits that you started with that measured great.
Yeah.
And then you weren't happy with the sound. Can you walk us through some of that process? Because a lot of people still don't understand the process of measuring, getting the measurements to look great, then listening, and it's not so great, and then what you would do to fix it.
Well, you know, so the process is, of course, starts with simulation. So I'm really into simulators.
Just to be clear, we're talking about circuit simulators.
Yes, that's correct. LT Spice is my favorite. There's others such as Tina and other Spice programs.
And maybe just give a brief explanation of what that actually means, because a lot of people don't know what do you mean it's simulating? Are you listening to music through it?
So what a simulator does is you can put together your circuit, you can draw your circuit in a simulator, and then you can attach models to each component that simulate the characteristics of that model. So for instance, resistors could be simple. You could tell the simulator to say, hey, make this resistor 30 ohms, and it will make it act like it's 30 ohms mathematically in this circuit. Of course, you know, resistors aren't just 30 ohms. Good ones are. Bad ones have other characteristics like inductance and all this. So you do have the option to put in other characteristics into your models, such as all these artifacts that you don't want. With the transistors, you can put in your exact transistor that the company has released. So if you're Texas Instruments and you release some sort of transistor or an op amp, they release the Spice model that you can then enter into LT Spice or any other Spice program. So then the program will actually run and act like it's the circuit and simulate the circuit and then give you all any output that you really want. So I can look at the circuit in many different ways.
But you're not listening to this.
Do not listen to it. This is a mathematical approach that the computer calculates and then spits out the outcome
in terms of measurement,
which is absolutely very, very important. To begin with, you have to understand the circuit, and some of the best ways to do this is now through Spice. Before, it used to be on the bench, which is fun. I mean, I'm sure that's what you did.
Back in my day, that's all we did, you know.
But I would argue that even though the bench is fun and it's great, and I do a lot of that as well, to start out with simulating your circuits is just an incredible tool, because you can, first thing, if there's something you don't understand about the circuit, you can start to go in and try to understand it by maybe manipulating things, looking at different points in the circuit, getting a lot of different outcomes. I mean, we're not just talking about THD. I can do transient analysis, I can do frequency response, I do noise analysis, I do loop analysis, where I look at stability, phase margins, gain margins, all of this. Okay, so that's the first step, is that I understand the circuit. This is not just something I conjure together and then hope that it works and I hope the DC values are right. It's calculated first. Okay, then I build it. Then I realize that, well, okay, the Spice simulations are not always right on. Why are they not right on? Because your components vary slightly in quality. The models are only so good. They're only so close to the real thing. So then I'll go to the AP and I'll start to measure that circuit that's built. And so now you're seeing the actual circuit operate. You'll be surprised how there are a lot of characteristics that are very close to the Spice simulation. So they certainly don't suck. if you do it well and you make sure that you have all of your spice models right. From there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, after I have it technically exactly the way I want it, I'm going to, and I feel that I've optimized the circuit, I'm going to listen to it, okay? And so this is what I did with the Stellar Phono preamp. It measured extremely well. The amplifiers had extremely high slew rates that exceed most audio-based.
And just so we understand, slew rate is how fast a signal can go from zero to somewhere up.
Yes. Okay. How much I can slew voltage in a certain period of time.
Yeah, so I just worry that people don't know what slewing is.
Oh, yes, yes.
It's a transient response, in a sense.
So how much can I raise the voltage? Mm-hmm. How much can an amplifier move? In a certain period of time.
Right. It can go from zero to 8 volts in
X
so many
amount
microseconds.
Of yeah. time. Exactly. Okay. Uh-huh. So that's what it does. So they were really fast amplifiers.
Yeah.
Wide bandwidth. The slew rate is not necessarily tied with bandwidth. You can limit bandwidth and still have slew rate. So they were wide bandwidth, high slew rate, and pretty high feedback amplifiers, actually. The distortion, I wasn't even really able to measure harmonics. They were it was below the AP. So this is a very good performance.
Yeah, and the AP will do 0.001?
APs are you're talking down to like negative 135 if you notch it and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
On the latest ones.
Yeah.
Somewhere around there.
Pretty
very
far
low.
Below human hearing. Yeah.
Very, very low.
Yeah.
So I listened to that and I was not exactly happy with what I heard. It was not bad. And I had beside it another design of mine, which was a really nice op amp design, like integrated circuit design.
So let's save this juicy part for tomorrow, or for the day after. We'll probably do this the day after. So we started with a spice simulation. So you built the thing in the computer.
Mm-hmm.
Then you went and you actually built the circuit. Now we go and listen to it.
Mm-hmm.
And we're not so happy with the results. All right, we're going to come back and figure out how that works and what we do with it. That
sounds
all right?
Good. Yep, okay. Sounds perfect.
All right.